Good morning, dear students. This is a small bit from GATE 2019 Set 1 Mechanical Engineering paper. Brake drum, shoe, and lever. This brake drum is revolving. It has been stopped by applying the force here. This force, part of force, reflects here and pushes the drum, and when it touches the drum there will be friction force between this brake drum and this shoe. This shoe will stop the rotation of the wheel, so it is revolving anti-clockwise direction. The important concept of taking the direction of force is important in this problem. So what is the direction of force? Many of the students will take the direction of force in this direction. When it is revolving in this direction, force is in this direction, frictional force. This frictional force is in this direction, correct, when you consider the rotation of the wheel. But when you take the shoe and lever, the frictional force is in this direction, because relative to this wheel, the brake shoe is moving in this direction. When you take, it is stationary. When it is revolving, relative to this, the friction force on drum is in this direction. Okay, that is the concept. Now, for analyzing the forces of equilibrium, you have to take this arm and shoe together as a one body and take moments. Take the moments. We will solve this problem. First, observe the configuration diagram. Observe the configuration diagram here. This is the brake drum revolving in anti-clockwise direction. And this is the arm. It is, which is pushed at the free end. Okay. This is the arm. This arm and shoe together is the one body. There is a friction, there is a reaction force between shoe and drum. So it will be upward. There is a friction force between drum and shoe. It is in left side direction related to this body. And there is a reaction force at fulcrum, that is Fa. So, given data, 250 Newton meter torque capacity, 2000 Newtons applied force, and the direction of rotation anti-clockwise with 100 rpm, and the coefficient of friction between shoe and drum is 0.25. Now, what is the free body diagram? It is configuration given diagram. Now, we can take free body diagram of this arm together with shoe. Okay. So here there are few forces on this total body. So what is applied force? F. There is a reaction force at B. There is a reaction force at A in downward direction. There is important force, that is friction force, in this direction between shoe and drum, that is F. So this F creates the braking torque. So when it is revolving, wheel is revolving in this direction with a certain torque, due to this frictional force there is a braking torque, will stop the wheel rotation. Okay. Now what is the friction force? According to friction law, friction force is directly proportional to the reaction, normal reaction. So this is the friction force, this is the normal reaction, that is F is equivalent to mu into Rb. F is equal to mu into Rb. Then what is the torque here? This is applied force F. This is the radius of wheel. This is force into this perpendicular distance is called torque. So that is F is equal to, T is equal to F into R. This T is equal to F into R. Assume this is the two equation, this is equation A, this is equation 1. And substitute this value 250 given data from data F into A, R is equivalent to A. Then friction force F is equivalent to 250 divided by A. Then what is RB? RB is equivalent to F divided by mu. RB is equivalent to F divided by mu. Substitute F value here, 250 divided by A into 0.25. We will get equations B and C. Now take the moments about point A. So this force will create moment force into this distance in anti-clockwise direction. Then this force, that is reaction force, will create, RB will create anti-clockwise moment, this force into this distance, anti-clockwise moment. Another force, friction force, important, F into A by 4, perpendicular distance from fulcrum. Then another force, RA into same distance, zero distance, is zero moment. Now sum the all moments, we will get the A value. So what are the moments? Take the moments about point A. This is B into total distance 1.5 A plus A total distance. So anti-clockwise moment P into 1.5 A plus A. Then RB creates clockwise moment RB into A. Negative, then F creates clockwise moment in this direction. That is F into A by 4. Then RA creates zero moment. So RA into zero distance. RA to A, that is zero. Sum all this. Then pull this two terms here. So P into 2.5 A is equivalent to RB into A plus FA divided by 4. Substitute the B and C equations in equation 2. In this, RB is 250 divided by 0.25 A into A. Then F is 250 divided by A into A by 4. Okay. Now here, extend this equation 2.5 into 2000, use the 5000 A is equivalent to 250, here A gets cancelled. Okay, 250 by 0.25. Then here also A by A cancel, A cancelled. 250 divided by 4. So pull this 250 outside. 250 into 0.25 into 250 into 1 by 4. Into plus 1 by 0.25. 1 by 0.25 is 4. 1 by 4. Here 5000 will come this side. A is equivalent to 250 something divided by 5000. So 00 get cancelled. 250 divided by 520. So this is 70 by 4 into 20 gives 17 by 80. So this is a value 0.2125 meters. So that is 213 mm. This is the answer. Gate problem important. Please subscribe this channel, share the video. Thank you.